India, US share freedom of religion. Drawing parallels between North Korea and Iran's nuclear ambitions, she said both countries' pursuit of nuclear weapons threatens all of us, but India holds nuclear capabilities as well but is widely respected. The U.S. envoy to the United Nations Nikki Haley Thursday asserted that freedom of religion is one of the most important and crucial things that India and U.S. share and that both nations can only be held together with tolerance. Haley, who is on a two-day maiden visit to India, is the first Indian-American to serve in a cabinet-level position in any U.S. presidential administration. She visited the Gauri Shankar Mandir, Jama Masjid, Gurudwara Ganj Sahib and Central Baptist Church this morning. While addressing an audience at a think tank here, Haley spoke about a variety of issues ranging from terrorism, freedom of religion, North Korea, China and more specifically Indo-US relations. She reiterated the US stand that Pakistan has become a haven for terror groups and that cannot be tolerated, adding that the US has already delivered the message to Islamabad. We share a commitment to defeating terrorism and the hateful ideology that motivates it. The US values Pakistan as a partner, but we cannot tolerate the state becoming a haven for terrorists and hope to see a change, she was quoted as saying by PTI. Speaking about India's membership into the elite nuclear suppliers group, NSG, Haley reaffirmed U.S. support to New Delhi and said that India, a nuclear state, is respected widely because it is a responsible democracy. Drawing parallels between North Korea and Iran's nuclear ambitions, she said both countries' pursuit of nuclear weapons threatens all of us. But India holds nuclear capabilities as well but is widely respected. North Korea dedicated their effort towards building nuclear forces and strong sanctions have curtailed them over time. Iran is a theocratic dictatorship and their pursuit of a nuclear weapons threatens all of us. On the other hand, India holds nuclear capabilities as well but is widely respected. This is because India is democratic and is a member of three non-proliferation groups. India and America share a natural friendship. Haley also praised India for the love bestowed on her when she said she's proud of the deep love for education amongst Indians. Indians have treated me like one of their own. As governor, I would begin all my speeches by mentioning that I am the daughter of Indian immigrants. The work ethic and deep love for education amongst Indians makes me proud, Anna quoted Haley as saying. She also hailed the U.S.-India relationship, saying it has grown from indifference and mutual suspicion to friendship and partnership. Today, Indian Americans are the most educated and highly philanthropic minority in U.S., she said. The U.S. leader also applauded India's vision for a free and open Indo-Pacific region, saying it is in line with U.S. President Donald Trump's vision. India's vision is aspirational but it is realistic, Haley said. Haley was, however, critical of U.S. relationship with China. She said although U.S. seeks productive relationship with Beijing, they do not share the same democratic values like U.S. Their expansion in the region without respect for rights unlike India will limit their relationship with U.S.